So we're all ready to head off on our next adventure. We're heading over to Facing Island out of Gladstone.
All right, ready?
Go!
All packed up and ready to go.
Fuck yeah.
Here we are, guys, Facing Island. We have made it. Now Australia Day can begin. Big shout out to Curtis Ferry for getting us over there and for also keeping us well hydrated on our trip with their $4 beers that they had on board. Now we can go and enjoy our afternoon on the beach before we go back and set up camp. So after about an hour on the beach, we headed back to find camp, and what a mint campsite it was. We were only meters off the beach, so time for dinner, and then let's hope we can catch some fish.
Have a go at that, guys. Pulled pork for the night. Right, look at this amazingness.
Alright, so we got wraps with pulled pork, coleslaw, and cheese, but Braden, the fella behind the camera right there, screwed mine up, so I just gotta suffer with what I've got.
With half a wrap. Hey, but we'll make it work,
well,
hey.
With half a wrap and a beer, anything's possible.
Hey, what's in the beer? Is it half full or half empty?
No, it's just pretty well half full.
Alright, that's it. That's what we want.
Cheers, that's a wrap.
Bloody there, lads, look at that. Beautiful.
Next day, we got up, had a coffee, and then decided to go for an explore around the island. We were camped up on the northwestern tip of the island, so we headed straight down the east side, saw all the beaches, pulled up for a bit of lunch, found some cool caves, picked some oysters off the rocks, Matty caught a good fish. It was a good day. We really enjoyed it.
I wanna know. on here, Matty.
So now we're just processing the fish. Get all the guts out of it, let it drain it. And we're going to sleep. And we can, this will be good for the lunchtime fire. Probably just grab it off the airport and let it salt pepper. Grab it out of the tunnels.
Sounds like a plan. And
maybe do some fish wraps. But yeah, Bob Sharp and Barney, how good.
After a good few hours trekking around the island, we had some lunch, did some fishing, just explored around a bit. We thought, yep, righto gang, it's time to head back to camp. So we had a look on the VMS and on the HEMA and we could see this track that went straight up the guts of the island. So we thought, yep, all right, let's find that. So we were on tracks, off tracks, and then we came to a mud flat and we all kind of looked at each other, looked at the HEMA and the VMS again. We're like, that track is right on the other side. Let's give it a go. But then this happened. The nav went down, but we managed to get her out without too much difficulty. And then the prado went through all right, so we thought, yep, righto, let's go find this track, get back to camp, and the adventure continued. So we found our track, followed it for a little bit, but unfortunately it came to a dead end. So we all looked at each other and went, we've got to go back through these mud flats. So off we went, turned around, headed back through, And that's where our long night started.
Right, so it's a nice little mischief. You got the old 80 bus covered in mud, head to toe. We got the snatch straps. More snatch straps. One snaps. All the way, all the way. To fucking this. Got the young fella working finally.
Young fella.
Time for the Prado to have a go.
We get around.
He was joining, right?
Well, knee swinging. After 6 hours, we are all out. Got this one recovered and both went down. And we just spent the last f***ing, 3 hours pulling both now. Yep, very nice. Wheel balance is on point. And have a look at. I'm jogging the whole time. Look how far we had to pull this. Still going. Just doesn't
end. Hey guys, Bayon here from Across Country Adventures. Just want to show you a bit of the carnage we had last night. We were following the HEMA, trying to go through different tracks, trying to find all these mainland tracks and that, and come to one spot where it's mud flats and we're humming and ahhing. Sent the 80 first, we put the nav in the middle of us, it got stuck, managed to get that out, sent the Prado across, we got through, had to send the drone up to try and find where more of the tracks went, managed to find a bit of a track and kept going for a bit to a point where we found a dead end. So we had to backtrack all the way back through the mud flats again, sent the 80 across first again, all sweet, sent the nav across, bogged again, spent hours and hours getting that through, and then sent the Prado and it got a meter and straight down the end of the chassis, and we were bogged there for hours too, and managed to skull drag the Prado all the way through the mud flats. Show you a bit of the carnage. So yeah, here's the Prado. Everything is just caked and just crap. It's just thick everywhere. Everything's covered in mud inside. Couldn't even open the doors, had to just keep crawling in and out of the car. Good times, good fun. But everything is just absolutely covered in just crap everywhere. Eddie looks pretty clean though. She done well. She was our fucking rescuer for the night. I think we first got bogged at 8 o'clock and we didn't get out till 12:30, 1 o'clock. The first time we got bogged wasn't too bad. Got out there pretty quickly, about an hour, if that, hour and a half. Let's go check out the nav. Nav got absolutely sprayed in mud. So we had the 80. Pulling the nav to pull the Prado out. Leaking, managed to get a bit of crap off of it this morning. Everybody's getting ready to go for a paddleboard. Everybody's on the beers, having fun. And have a go at this. She just got annihilated by the 80. Poor girl.
Annihilated by the fucking saucepans.
Yeah, a few broken straps. What did we go through? Three straps.
Everyone's annihilated.
Yeah. We lost a couple of covers and then I put on the nav because the straps snapped and just destroyed them. Yeah, we lost two max tracks. Everything's just caked in it. Yeah. But good times, good fun, eh? We all enjoyed. We went to bed about 4:30 after dinner and just passed out. Matty Fisher special bolognese.
Ooh. Yum yum.
So ingredients. You got 500 grams of mince. Some boneless pork spare ribs. That was a tasty little treat in between your mince. Then you just got your tomato paste, garlic infused oil, black dog sauce, diced tomatoes. Some bullseye habanero.
Ooh.
That's good shit. Bug sauce and passata.
Passata.
Gotta love a bit of passata.
Key ingredients to a good stag.
Nice. Hell yeah. Well,
you want me to fucking cut anything up?
Yeah, we'll cut up some onions if they've defrosted them up. I haven't put the heat on that, so what we'll do is traditionally you'd cook a stag, you'd put your onions in. Ground them off, then you put your mince in, ground them off, and then put all your sauces and everything else. So after that, what I do, or what I like to do, is I like to just put it all in, then turn the heat on, and then everything will build up slowly. You keep your juices from your mince, which will then in turn slow cook your pork spare ribs, and then obviously with all the juices, all the meats, and all that, them flavours are infused to what it is.
Nice. Sounds good to me.
And but frozen onions.
But see, I've got a secret ingredient.
Oh.
Ooh. Secret ingredient that not a lot of people know about.
Ooh.
Fresh cracked Bundy rum.
Ah. This is the secret ingredient.
Never tried this, just seen it at Woolies. So we got onion, garlic and chilli.
Yum.
All in the one. And I've dipped my finger in this, tasted it, and this would actually be very good with just your cracker chips or with your jats. It would be an unreal dip just on its own. So.
Would be good. I reckon that's going to go well in there.
Yeah, so we'll give that a run.
Righto, let's get this happening. Hell yeah.
Very simple.
How many things?
The idea of the game is to get 50 points, all right? If you knock these over and say you get 3 down, it's not 674, it's only 4 points. If you knock single 7 down, then it's 7 points.
How's that work?
That's the way it is, man. That's the way it is.
So all you gotta do is knock down a single number.
Or knock down how many things
to get the value of that.
No. If you knock down one, you get the value on it. If you knock down multiple, you get how many you knocked down.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Right.
And but if you get...
If you go over 50, you have to go back 10 plus. So if you got 30 and you hit the 12, you have
if
to
you
go
got
back
40 and you hit the 12,
that's
bad
the
man.
One.
Yeah.
That's the number.
Yeah.
See, with numbers, yeah.
How many times have I found you here with sadness in your eyes? Don't you remember that every life has a story that is full of broken ends and new?
How are you looking?
Looking pretty good there, mate.
Oh, look at that.
Getting the old trusty fork out. Give her a little stir.
Oh, beautiful.
Little pork chunks in there.
We even threw some mushrooms in there too.
Yeah, it looks, tastes good. Good pasta.
Time to get the pasta on, eh?
So after another awesome feed for dinner, we hit the pillow pretty early that night. I think we're all still pretty wrecked from our adventures the night before. So the next day we got up, it was our last day on the island, had a few hours before we needed to catch the barge back to Gladstone. So went for a quick drive down around the western side of the island, see what else we could find. Saw a few beaches, different things, but 2 hours before the barge, Matty decides to drive out on the beach and this happens.
I found you here right beside me, saying all the things you'd never done.
Trying the winch and then a few goes on the snatch straps as well, we got him out. Thank God. We only had about 45 minutes before we had to catch the barge, so that was it. We beelined it out of there. That was our final stitch up for facing island. Off we went, get on the boat. Three hard days cleaning, she turned up good as new. So thanks Facing Island for such a good adventure, and thanks to our friends Luke, Emma and Maddie for coming with us. Was a hell of a trip, but definitely keen to do it again.